value of module which we will get by solving the equation is 4.1 mm. From the standard table, we shall consider the standard values. So table 12.2. From the table 12.2 recommended series of modules, so we have got the value as 4.1. We shall take the value of phi. Usually we shall take values of module higher values so that we'll get the design as safe. From table 12.2, page number 229. Now once we get the value of module, we can find the diameters. D1 is equal to mz1 and D2 is equal to mz2. Phi into z1 is 20 and z2 is 78. So the values of diameter which we'll get as from this equation is 100 mm, and this is 390. Face width B is equal to 10 mm. Face width B, K is equal to B by M. So B is 10 into M. M is 5, so it is 50. Now we shall take the Lewis equation and we will take for FT and we will check for sigma. Sigma d we shall take for allowable stresses. Ft is equal to pi sigma d cv bym. This equation is equation 12.5a, page number 204. So in this equation we'll find the value of Ft by using another equation. Tangential force Ft in terms of torque, Ft is equal to 2mt by d, page number 12.8a, 206. Here we have considered this equation because we will find all the values and we will check for sigma d. We had done this in previous session also. If the value of sigma d is less than the allowable stresses which we have assumed in initial starting problem, then the design is safe. Otherwise we need to change the module. So we shall check for the design. Page number 206, equation 12.8a. The value of MT we have found out, it is 382 into 10 power 3 Newton mm divided by D is D2, because design is based on gear. The value of D2 is 390. So the value of FT I'll get as the value of FT I'll get as 1959 newtons. This is the value of FT I'll get. Next we shall find the value of velocity. V equals pi dn by 60. This is n2 d2 because design is based on gear. D2 is 390 and N2 is 300 by 60. The value of velocity which I'll get as 6.13. So for the velocity 6.13, we need to find the value of CV. They have given the value of CV up to 8 meter per second, we have to take this. And if it is up to 13 meter per second, we have to take this equation. Since the value which we have got as 6.13 meter per second, so we shall take this equation. Here I need to include 10 power 3. Because the value of diameter, it is in terms of 390 mm. So to convert it to meter, I am dividing it by 10 power 3. So I have got the velocity as 6.13 meter per second. So now the value of CV is 3.05 divided by 3.05 plus V. This is from equation 12.6A. Page number 205. So it is 3.05 divided by 3.05 plus V 6.13. So the value of CV which I'll get is 0.332. Now we shall substitute all the values CV, FT, all the values in this equation, B, Y, M, all the values we have. We shall find the value of sigma D. B is 50, y is pi into y2, it is 0.1152 into m module, it is 5. So the value of sigma d2 which we will get as 65.25 MPa, and this is less than the value which we had assumed during starting of the problem, 78.5 MPa. So since the induced stresses is less than the allowable stresses, the design is safe and we can proceed further. Now in next stage we shall find the value of dynamic tooth load. So to find the dynamic tooth load, we have dynamic load FD is equal to FT plus K3V, equation 12.12, page number 207. And for the value of K3, they have given the value of K3 as 20.67, and we have to find the value of C. This is equation 12.12, page number 207. For the value of C, we shall refer table 12.14. So here you can see maximum allowable or permissible error in action between gears. So the velocity which I have got in the problem is 6.1 meter per second. So I will take 6 meter per second, and for that corresponding value the error is 0.059. By using this value we will come to again table 12.12, error is 0.059, but here there is 0.06. There is no 0.059, so we shall take the value for 0.06 only. The material combination is here cast iron and steel. The material combination is cast iron and steel, steel and the tooth is 14.5 degree tooth form, and error is for 0.06. I'll take the value of CS 454.8. For error is equal to 0.06. What is the value of C for error? 0.059. So because this was the real value, this is from table 12.14, page number 237, and table 12.12, page number 236. So this is nothing but cross multiplication. For C, this value, for error 0.06, and for what is the value of C for error 0.059. So this is simply cross multiplication. C is equal to 0.059 into 454.8 divided by 0.06. So the value of C I'll get as 447.22 Newton per mm. Now we shall find the value of dynamic tooth load. We have all the values. We can easily find the value of FT. FT we had found just now, 1959, plus the value of K3 is 20.63. It was given in the data handbook. Here it is, K3 20.67. Into V is velocity, it is 6.13. Into again C, 447.22. Into B is 50 plus FT. FT is 1959. Divided by K3V plus square root of CB FT. Again K3 is 20.67. Into V is 6.13 plus square root of C is 447.22 into B is 50 plus FT is 1959. So by solving this equation I'll get the value of dynamic tooth load FD as 12.86 kilonewton. Dynamic tooth load FD is equal to 12.86 kilonewton. Next we have to find the value of endurance force. Endurance force you can find from equation 12.13a, page number 207. Here we need to find the value of endurance stress. This is equation 12.13a, page number 207. So to find the endurance strength, we shall go to table 12.15, endurance limit. The material hardness, and they are given the endurance stress. The material for gear is cast iron. Our material is cast iron, and in this table you can see that there is a gray cast iron and the hardness is 160. So we shall go to this next table, 12.16. here you can see it, they are given the material and hardness for pinion and gears, and they are given the endurance limit and K. We shall take the value of cast iron. Since our material for gear was cast iron, we shall take this and the hardness is 180 and the endurance limit is 343. We shall select this combination, and the corresponding value of K for 14 and a half degree system is 0.304. We shall take this value. This is from table 12.16, page number 239. We have value of BYM, so we can find the value of endurance force. Since this is MPa, we shall consider this as Newton per mm square. The value of B is 50. And y is pi 0.1152 into module is 5, module m is 5. So the value of endurance force which I'll get is 31.02 kilonewton, and this value endurance force is greater than dynamic load, and hence therefore material is safe. The endurance force, it should be greater than the dynamic tooth load. So in this problem, the endurance force is greater than dynamic force, so the material is safe. Material is safe against static tooth load. You have to write this comment. If the combination is less, we have to repeat the design. So next, we shall find the value of wear load. Wear load FW, it is available in the value of wear load. The limiting load for wear FW is equal to D1BQK, and for Q they have given the value is 2Z2 by Z2 plus Z1. So we shall take these equations from page number 208, these two equations. D1 is 100, B is 50, Q we shall find directly here, 2 into Z2 the value of Z2 is 78 by Z2 plus Z1, 78 plus the value of Z1 is 20 into K. K we had considered 0.304. So the value of FW which I'll get from this equation is 2.42 kilonewtons. The value of FW I'll get is 2.42 kilonewton. FW is less than FD. So in our values, the value 2.42, it is less than dynamic tooth load, FD is 12.86. So therefore, the opinion is subjected to rapid wear. The pinion is subjected to rapid wear and hence have to be surface hardened. So we have to harden this surface. We have to choose the BHN for a higher value. And BHN has to be selected. You write this comment, this is enough. So no need to find the value of BHN, because I will tell you why. From the table, they are given for materials for both pinion and gear. Our combination which we had considered was for pinion we had assumed material as steel, and for gear we had assumed as cast iron. So now we have got the value, we had assumed the value of K as 0.304. Now to change the hardness we need to change the value of K, but for the given combination, steel and cast iron combination, the values of K you can see here, it is very less. It is less than 1 or almost equal to 1. So you cannot select the higher value of K. Even if you select the higher value of K, you will not get the values of wear load greater than FD. So the better option is just writing the wear load has to be, the pinion is subjected to rapid wear and hence have to be surface hardened, and BHN have to be selected with higher number. With higher number, that is they have to select for hardness as higher number. You write this much comment, it is enough. No need to change the value of K and doing again, because for the given material combination, pinion and gear combination, the value of K is this much, 0.3, and it is up to 1. And if we use, we will not get the value FW greater than FD. So the better is writing this much. Thank you, guys.